NASA got a huge Christmas gift this morning when it successfully launched its most powerful space telescope ever.
We have engine start.
And liftoff.
Decollage,
liftoff from a tropical rainforest to the edge of time itself. James Webb begins a voyage back to the birth of the universe.
The launch of the James Webb telescope was more than 20 years in the making, involving thousands of scientists, multiple countries, and it will likely change the way we see the universe. CNN space correspondent Kristen Fisher is covering the launch for us this morning. Kristen, this rocket still has a pretty perilous journey ahead, though.
It does, Jessica. Good morning. And they actually, NASA has a name for it. It's called the 29 Days on Edge. You know, anytime there's a Mars rover or a rover that tries to land on Mars, they have that 7 minutes of terror where they lose communication with the rover. Well, for the Webb Space Telescope, it's going to take 29 days for it to fully get into its final configuration. There's more than 300 single points of failure as this massive tennis court-sized telescope literally unfolds like an origami in space. And it's going to be doing it as it travels a million miles away from Earth. So, Jessica, if anything goes wrong, this is not like the Hubble Space Telescope where astronauts can go out and do a spacewalk and fix it. This is going out to a point in space called L2. It's the second Lagrange point. It's orbiting the sun, and it's so far away that no astronaut is going to be able to repair it. So everything has to go perfectly right. But let's just take a moment and marvel at what happened this morning. This is a moment literally 3 decades in the making. There have been so many delays. There have been so many moments where the Webb telescope might not have happened. Today, for it to successfully launch from French Guiana, what an incredible moment for NASA and all of those scientists and engineers who've made it possible.
I know, it gives me chills listening to you describe all of it. You talked about the delays, though, and it's been decades in the making. Walk us through a little bit of what it took to get to this point.
Well, there have been financial issues. I mean, it's $9 billion over budget. It was supposed to launch initially 10 years ago. So this is 10 years delayed, $9 billion over budget. There have been political constraints. There have been issues about the telescope's names. And one of the other things was simply getting this telescope to the launch pad in French Guiana. Jessica, think about this. I mean, it's massively expensive, right? You have to put this telescope on a ship, sail it to French Guiana because it's so big. And one of the things that they were so worried about, or that they had to at least consider, was the possibility of pirates potentially trying to, steal this very expensive telescope. Of course, that did not happen, but that was part of the reason. There was a little bit of secrecy involved in terms of letting the public know exactly when and where this telescope was. So it avoided any pirates. The telescope avoided any, issues during launch. Now we just have to keep our fingers crossed and hope that everything goes okay over the next 29 days. But as of now, Jessica, everything looks great. The solar arrays have unfurled. It is getting its own power from the sun right now. And there's a press conference happening right now, and everybody on the ground says everything looks great. So let's hope it stays that way.
Absolutely. 29 days, you said, on edge. We'll wait and see what happens. Mm. And Kristen, it's so good to see you. My old friend, we go way back to our beginning days in television in Little Rock together. Merry Christmas to you, my friend.
Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. Good to see you, too.
Let's get more on this historic launch now. Adam Frank is an astrophysicist at the University of Rochester and the author of the book Light of the Stars, Alien Worlds, and the Fate of the Earth. It's so great to see you. Listening to Kristen describe all of this, is it overstating things to say this could change the way we see the universe?
I don't think so, that at all. Well, first of all, Merry Christmas. And it seemed like Santa was riding a rocket today for all of us. It's not an understatement. I mean, you think about Hubble Space Telescope, which was the most successful scientific instrument in the history of humanity, how much that changed. It saw alien planets that we'd never seen before. It showed us the environments of black holes. It really, Hubble, literally every Marvel movie you see they have a scene in space, they're using the Hubble Space Telescope image. So James Webb will do the exact same thing, but it's 100 times more powerful. So yeah, it's gonna rewire our understanding of the universe.
it's like mind blowing. So, okay, so you say it's 100 times more powerful than the Hubble telescope, and it sees in infrared. So what does that mean for astronomers and people who are going to be using these images?
Well, there's two things. So, you know, infrared light is light that's, you know, longer than the wavelengths of light that our eyes are sensitive to. And for astronomers, that's important for two reasons. Because one, it allows us to see very far back to the, literally when the universe was just a little teeny tiny baby. And there's so much about how we went from the chaos of the Big Bang to now the structured, orderly universe that's got things like galaxies and stars and planets in it. And infrared light is really the only way to really see those baby galaxies. So that's one thing we're going to see. We're going to see literally the dawn of time. And then the other thing that's super important is exoplanets. We now know, thanks to Hubble and other telescopes, that every star you see in the sky hosts a family of worlds, of alien worlds. And with the James Webb telescope, we're going to be able to see the atmospheres. We're going to be able to peer into the atmospheres of those planets and see what they're made of: carbon dioxide, oxygen, sulfur. Perhaps even be able to see whether there's life on those worlds by seeing whether or not there's chemicals in the atmosphere that would indicate a biosphere. So, you know, that's pretty amazing.
I'd say so, yes. And you're talking about seeing the dawn of time and earlier galaxies, because this telescope's been described as kind of as a time machine that's going to allow us to see some of these earliest galaxies. For someone like a layman like me in all of this, how does that work? How, help us understand how we can see back in time.
Yeah, you know, it's really one of the most freaky deaky things about science. So the speed of light is finite. Like, it takes a certain amount of time for light to travel from, you know, like this computer screen to my eye. If you're looking at someone who's a foot away, you're not really seeing them as they are. You're seeing them as they were a nanosecond ago. Like, think about that. So everything in the room that you're looking at is actually a few instants old when you're seeing it. Now, when you look at distant astronomical objects, it gets even more extreme. If I'm looking at something that's 1 light year away, I'm seeing it when the light was emitted 1 year ago. 1,000 light years away, 1,000 years ago. When you're looking at these early galaxies, we're literally looking 13.5 billion years into the past. So they're 13.5 billion light years away. That's not really entirely correct, but that's about it. And so we're seeing it 13.5 billion years in the future. In the past.
Right. That is incredible. Absolutely incredible. I'm like sitting here absorbing this information. I'm learning so much. So getting this, Kristen talked a little bit about what it took to get this telescope into space. It was delayed multiple times. It went over budget. There were concerns about pirates as they were, you know, had to put it on a ship and get it to its launch site. It has about 1 million miles to go. And it's going to take a while to get there, about a month. When you think about all the things that could go wrong, you know, are you concerned that this maybe won't quite make it? Or, you know, are you nervous or on edge? It sounds like you're pretty excited about it. I'm pretty excited about it now, too. You know, what are the biggest dangers ahead?
Well, I'm super pumped about it and have been for a long time. I'm also totally freaked out because this thing, if you want to understand what this thing is, you got to think transformer in space, right? Mm-hmm. It's like a soup can, which now has to unfold into a 20-foot wide space telescope. And so there are so many moving parts. This was an audacious plan by NASA, but it's what you have to do if you need a large telescope, which you have to have to observe the kind of things we want. You can't have it fully assembled in the rocket. You gotta have it assemble itself in space. So there are many, many ways this things could fail. And that's why it took so long. It was really a bold and audacious plan. And I'm going to be on edge until we do it. But you know, the beautiful thing here is this is a gift that, like, we give ourselves, right? Right? The last 2 years have been pretty hard on all of us. Mm-hmm. And what this is mm-hmm. thousands of human beings all working together to produce something amazing. And I think it's going to work. And when it does work, we're all going to be able to sort of have a little bit of confidence in ourselves that as human beings, as, you know, hairless monkeys, we can do amazing things when we work together.